3-4 shows that I watch.
Yeah. Yes.
This is one of my favorites here, right? Yeah. It's called The Glades. It's on A&E. It's back for second season. Our guest plays a Chicago homicide detective forced to relocate to the Florida Everglades, where murders rise. Are on the rise. What am I reading? Anyway, go to the clip and then
we'll... Can you watch the show?
No. I'm just going to stay here and maybe just watch some races. Whoops. Sat on these.
Hey, awesome. Hey, I was wondering where I put these.
Actually, you left them in Josh's hotel room. You know, where you weren't last night? And I hate to be crass and all, but you just graduated from person of interest to suspect. So now, you get to come with me. Come on. I'll be here all week.
All right, you get to come with me. Come on. I'll be here all morning if you... This is Matt Passmore.
He loves your show.
Oh, nice.
Hi,
hey,
I'm
guys.
Lauren.
Nice to meet you.
Come, have a seat.
I like that you're surrounded by beautiful women in bikinis a lot in this movie.
Nothing's changed, huh?
In this show, yeah.
Is that why you're watching the show? I thought it was something about content.
No, actually it's about the characters. It's really about that's why people watch that show. The plots are okay, but it's all about you and how strangely attractive, charming, and neurotic and conflicted.
Boy,
you've
got me in one.
Yeah, okay.
It's a character-driven cop procedural, and it's more about how these characters move through the space and what this guy is going to do to solve the murders, as opposed to just hey.
Yeah,
you know,
and also he's in love with, but not in love with, and then he's got a woman there, and he doesn't have her.
And you're what? You're a New Yorker?
No, Australian.
Australian? Listen to his accent.
Are
you joking?
Close.
Yes!
Oh, I was like, hold on, wait, facetiousness.
This is shocking. This is shocking, because I've seen every episode of this series.
Wow.
You and Curb Your Enthusiasm, a couple of
And that's pretty much all you watch.
And well, a lot of news and sports, but... to hear you, and I know you're from Australia, and I knew you were at the McLeods, and you know, and you did that little film noir thing
right.
in Sydney. I know you're from Australia, but to hear you sound that way is a shocker, because you never sound that way on the show.
So you have an American accent on the show.
I do, yeah, with a little twinge of Chicago in there.
Yeah.
We didn't go the full Chicago thing, but
Chicago,
you know, I try
like
to put
that.
a little twinge in
is
there.
Is it? Well, obviously, it's not difficult for Australian actors because you guys do very well over here. But is it hard?
I've always found it quite easy. But of course, we've had American television for a long time in Australia, especially
mm-hmm.
post World War II, a huge American influence. So growing up with Gilligan's Island and the Brady Bunch and that sort of thing. I mean,
you learn how to talk American.
American, yes.
You know Chicago. How's this Chicago?
Give me a little more. Come on.
A little Chicago?
Well, that's he's
a little up in there. I mean, I don't do a full Chicago.
Yeah,
Everyone in Chicago
do
at the moment.
Do you find yourself going in and out, though, sometimes? Ever? Do they have to catch you? Like, you go back, you revert back to your regular voice?
I keep it a lot of the time during the day of shooting because, you know, at 4 o'clock on a Saturday morning after a big week and I'm tired, a big Aussie vowel can just poke its ugly head out. So I keep it, but then quite often they say, all right, that's a wrap for today. And I go, you beauty, thanks, guys. And you know, some guest cast or whatever sort of kind of, oh,
they didn't know until that moment. I have a question for you that fans always ask. I know Florida pretty well. Where is this taking place? One moment you're in Fort Lauderdale, you cross the street and you're in Orlando. I mean, how does that work out?
Yeah, I mean, look, Palm Glade is a fictional place, probably somewhere rural, in the middle of Florida, somewhere down below Tampa or
Except
something like that.
Except when it's on the beach.
Except when it's at the beach. But see, that's why we're the FDLE, we're the feds,
yes.
You know, we're the federal police.
The federal
so we can
police.
Go anywhere.
Yes.
And
yes.
So
do you shoot here?
Never
do you
that
shoot?
Far from a beach.
Exactly. You know, and in fact, the beach is just, the big high rises go straight up against the swamp. So it makes for such an eclectic place.
Mm-hmm. Where do you guys shoot?
We film around the Fort Lauderdale area,
Hallandale, okay.
North Miami.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then, of course, out in the Glades.
How do you like living down there?
It's, I mean, I had this fantastic condo looking out over the water, so it's the best place to learn lines I think I've ever
is it
filmed
like,
in.
Is it like the house that you live in on the show?
Not quite like that, okay. but I wish.
There's not as many women running through it.
No, not.
More funny
enough, not.
Than chicks?
Definitely a lot more gators, yeah. Although, when you see a few lovely ladies, you know, that have been tanning their whole lives, same kind of skin tone as the gators down there.
Yeah. It's good up to about 33, right?
Yeah, they make a great purse if you just do a few skin grafts.
Oh, my goodness.
You just lost a lot of fans, but.
But Steve will still watch.
Right, as long as Steve watches.
You have a relationship with Keely Sanchez on the show.
Yes.
That is very, very complicated.
Is this one Keely?
And somewhat, no, this is okay. Just casual. Thing. And somewhat, somewhat perplexing.
Just random bikini girl, you know.
Somewhat perplexing and somewhat annoying to some of the fans, as you know. They
right.
Do it or don't do it, right?
Yeah. Clifton Campbell wrote this relationship to be very complex. Most television. Especially procedurals work on just a simmering tension that can last for however many episodes. Ours isn't so much about tension, but about obstacles. Mm-hmm. So already, guy meets girl, guy finds out that girl is married to a guy in prison, has a child, and all the complexities that come with that.
Right. So and you have a girlfriend from Chicago.
A girlfriend from Chicago comes back, or an old flame who broke his heart, and that's really what happens when an old flame comes back into your life.
So, let me ask you this. Can love conquer all?
Yeah, I mean, there's one thing that Clifton really did in this series was that there may be other women that look great on paper that might be better for Jim, but he just can't get away. His heart.
He comes back, but also he's kind of an idiot because there are moments.
No, that's
there
what are I bring moments, to the role. Actually,
there are moments when she suddenly lets her guard down. Every time she lets her guard down, he gets stupid.
Well, he's a bloke. He's got absolutely no idea.
No clue.
As you women very well know, just guys have no idea. And
really, are they really that? I mean, do guys really have no idea?
Hopeless. Absolutely.
And can you be a bloke in Florida?
I tried to be. I mean, you know, alongside the pink flamingos and the floral shirts.
Let me mention about shirts. They save a lot of budget on this show because you wear one T-shirt for the entire series.
I just want to say right now.
Yeah, I plugged this from the show.
After that comment, you have another fan. I will be watching the Glades. Let me tell you.
Hey, Matt, pleasure to meet you.
Thank nice
you
to meet
so
you, guys.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
The Glades Sunday nights at 10 on A. And E. Coming up, how alcohol is good for your brain.
See? I knew I was doing something right.
Ashton Kutcher living well on the set. Huh?
Oh my God, you have to see his trailer. Have you seen this?
Don't look.
I have
you saw
it.
He's actually living.
Why haven't I got that trailer?